Interview retells ugly meltdown at news offices as Trump swept election night. The collective meltdown Democrats had on election night when they realized Donald Trump would be next president of the United States was off the charts. Conservatives will likely remember the night with glee as they realized how utterly wrong the polls and Democrats were that predicted Clinton would undoubtedly win. Many will also remember, with a sigh of relief, that one of the most arrogant and corrupt campaigns of modern history failed to accurately gauge the will of the people. Others, namely liberal Democrats, will remember that night as a soul-crushing blow that ripped their world to shreds. Esquire magazine interviewed some of those people to get an inside look at what was going through the heads of those who controlled the narrative for decades, and it's about as ugly as you can imagine. Esquire interviewed 40 people who either covered the election or worked on one of the campaigns, and their stories represent the dangers of living in a bubble. New Yorker magazine writer Rebecca Traister recalled how alone she felt when she realized Clinton lost. "I felt so alone, I knew it was done. I was by myself on the floor. I started to cry," Traister said. "People were throwing up. People were on the floor crying," she recalled. Former CNN host Reza Aslan described how he had a panic attack when he heard Trump won. "My wife stayed up and I went to sleep, then she woke me up around 1 or 2 in the morning bawling and told me that it was over. My poor, sweet wife. She wanted to hug and kiss me but I went into a panic attack and couldn't breathe," he wrote, as reported by Esquire. CNN political commentator Simone Sanders said she was in shock. "I still couldn't believe it was happening. When he talked about us coming together and healing for the country, I wanted to throw up in my mouth," she said. New York Times writer Michael Barbaro said he lost a sense of direction. "I went home and woke up my husband, I think it was 4 or 5 in the morning, and asked him what the next steps should be journalistically. Should I move to Washington? Should I change jobs? It was pretty disorienting," he said. There's little doubt that liberals far and wide were disoriented with the election results. What's especially telling about these meltdowns is the fact that 1 year later, Democrats are still as distraught as they once were. The left still spews an inordinate amount of hate Trump's way instead of working on getting over it. Clinton encouraged a resistance movement and activists have called for fighting in the streets. Meanwhile, Trump is turning this country around. The economy is roaring. The Islamic State terror group is losing control and Americans are optimistic. Trump is still winning.